Licuanan, who was on Headstart, I think, two or three weeks ago, admitted that the CHED took on too much, when it came to the scholarships for the teacher scholars of the K-12 program. But she did say at one point that the allowances were already released. Mm-hmm. Were there still delays left? Or when she left?
More than 1,000 scholars still.
And the delays were, are we talking about a year? 2 years?
2016, so more than a year. Looking back, of course, the decision on how to design the K-12 program was done before my time.
Yeah.
I already, when I got to the commission, it was already moving. And looking back, there were things that were wrong in the design.
In itself.
The decision of the commission or the chair to create a K-12 transition team to run it and attach it or make it accountable to the office of the chair, this was a non-plantilla type of organization. Mm-hmm. These were contractuals, young contractual people who were running a 5 billion peso program.
So it was a lack of experience?
Yes, many of them were, I mean, they tried hard, but they didn't know the rules of government. When they were designing the scholarship program, there were requirements that the Commission on Audit said later on was not correct.
I see.
So there's a learning curve if you get young people on contractual basis. There's no accountability because if they make mistakes, they can just resign and get out of their contract. So that was
one.
The other is they took on too many scholars.
Okay.
9,500 of them. You know, Karen, how many 9,500 is?
Yeah.
It's like the enrollment of a private university already.
Wait, a clarification to all our viewers. When Professor De Vera talks about scholars, he means scholars. They are all teachers.
These are professors who are finishing their master's and their PhD. Just too many of them. So you combine the fact that you have an organizational structure that is not very stable with too many scholars, you're courting disaster.
Did you bring this up with Chair Licuanan when you were a member of the committee?
Of course. Okay. We took it up in at least 3 en banc meetings because the complaints were everywhere. I was getting it when I go around the country to talk. There were a lot of complaints. I think the third mistake was the program was designed to address and deal with individual scholars.
Okay.
Simply, mathematically, you cannot deal with 9,500 units or people.
Yeah.
So the first thing that I did when I tried to address the problem was to cluster them.
Okay.
So the point of contact is not individual scholars. Yeah. It is schools.
Yes.
So I said cluster the problematic scholars around schools and deal with the school.
Uh-oh.
Call the president, ask for a meeting, bring the scholars there, get the register there, get the congressman, because they would complain to their representatives in Congress, and bring the K-12 team, and don't leave the school until the documents are finished.
Uh-oh.
Stay there the whole day.
So this implementation, you did this when Licuanan definitely was still, still chair.
Yes, okay. I took over responsibility in addressing the problem.
Uh-oh.
And just in a week's time, 600 scholars got their stipend by just dealing with at least 5 big universities where most of them are faculty members.
Uh-oh.
So there is a sense of urgency. The other thing that we did is we found out that a lot of the disallowances was because of COA regulations. So we sought a meeting with COA. I asked Speaker Bebot Alvarez for help, and Congressman Freddy Shaw and Coco Nograles met with the chair of COA to try to address it. And now the COA resident auditor in CHED is working with the K-12 staff to look at the disallowances and take out those that are not necessary.
Yeah.
That will address maybe another 500 scholars.
Yeah.
Because so I'm sure, and I am confident that maybe in 1 to 2 weeks time, all the problematic scholars would have been addressed.
Okay. Because when Licuanan was here, she said, "I apologize to, I think she claims 1,000 plus were left.
Yes.
That didn't have their allowances, and she said that they couldn't give it if they had no enrollment forms.
Yeah, yeah.
Is that still the situation?
No. Out of that 1,000 plus,
yeah,
the problematic scholars are now less than 500. And if the discussions with the COA resident auditor would be good, mm-hmm, that would be zero backlog.
Okay.
Maybe in 2-3 weeks' time, there would be no more problems.
Okay. Yeah. So, Professor, now that you're sharing this, is it really the fact that she traveled excessively, or frankly, she, I mean, there were management issues.
Yeah.
I mean, what was the truth? Was the, were the excessive travels just a reason, when the truth was, management-wise, she could not handle the problems of the CHED with K-12?
Again, I don't know the discussion with the executive secretary, but what I know is that the president instructed the executive secretary and the special assistant to the president, Bongo, to look into the allegations of the travel.
Yeah.
I don't know what their investigation resulted in. But the management issues in CHED, I think, are the real problems.
Yeah.
Because it is inhuman to not give allowances to
teachers.
Teachers. They have families to feed. They have apartments to rent for those who moved from the provinces to Metro Manila. And this should have been addressed more urgently, because every single day that this passes, there are scholars who stopped studying because you need your allowances. They're not getting their salaries from their universities. They're relying on the stipends that they have.
Mm-mm.
So to me, that is the bigger problem that had to be solved in the commission.
Uh-oh.